Hi. Hello and welcome to the Weird Side of YouTube. My name is Adeline Warren and today I'm gonna be showing you guys a go-to makeup look that I always do on my Instagram and stuff like that. You guys are always like, where's the tutorial? I don't see a tutorial. And I'm like, I don't know, I guess I'll do it. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe. How to go from a potato to human. Vanessa Hudgens' sister, a unicorn with cake. I love makeup. Makeup is my art, and makeup also makes me feel like Beyonce. This tutorial is gonna show you how to be your own Beyonce. We're all Beyonces on this planet, girl, guy, whatever you is. You are gorgeous, and everybody likes different things about other people. Like, I love freckles, and I know that my boyfriend like hates freckles. So you are the perfect person for someone, and you are beautiful, and I'm gonna teach you how to do art on your face to make you look like a Kardashian or a Beyonce or like a Vanessa Hudgens mix, you know? You gotta express what's on the inside, on the outside. I'm just obnoxious. But I have all my makeup. And really quick, I wanted to show an outfit of the day. PG-13. I'm gonna show you an outfit of the day.
Real quick, this is my filming setup. I just got this TV. It's like, okay, too big of an intro. But this is my outfit of the day, real quick. And I curled my hair yesterday, so it's like that loose Vanessa Hudgens wave. But this choker is from Forever 21. Shirt is from a thrift store. Like, seriously, like, you could get so many good things at a thrift store. This is from the thrift store, too, and it's like a Levi jacket. My leggings are from Lululemon, and then my shoes are from Skechers. Shoe model. This is their Delights 10-year anniversary version. Wow! I didn't know I could do that. It's their four-piece collection, and it's their 10-year anniversary of it. Because it's, like, so, like, 90s fashion, I kind of think so. And I have, like, the 90s, like, jean. We have the choker. We're going, like, all 90s right now. You know how Kylie's trying to bring, like, the juicy stuff back? I feel like this is gonna come back, too, because it's, like, I don't know, like, the little chunky sneakers. All of the shoes have, like, the Skechers of memory foam inside. So it's just, like, it's so comfy. It's like walking on a cloud. And it, like, makes me a little bit taller because I'm, like, so short. That is the outfit of the day on to the makeup tutorial. But also, thank you, Skechers, for sponsoring this video. I love you guys so much. Actual makeup tutorial now. Okay. Sorry if I'm talking really fast. Ah! I'm just, like, really caffeinated. And by the way, that's a pimple. I popped it this morning. I probably shouldn't have, but it was like so satisfying. Like, when I went on tour, this is like all the makeup that I would bring, and this is just what I normally go to. It's my go-to makeup tutorial. Primer. I love using the Smashbox primer. Before, I would never use primers in high school, but I found out like it actually makes a difference. Ooh. Whoa, Adeline, wow, I wondered why people make primers. It's like clear, you don't notice a difference, but like it does make a difference. I have like a Smashbox photo finish foundation primer. I just like to put it in the back of my hand and then rub it in with my fingers. I don't really use a beauty blender for this part. I forgot who it was. James Charles. James Charles said in a makeup tutorial not to put too much primer on your nose area because then your foundation will like move around and stuff like that. So don't do that. I feel like, you know that meme on Twitter, and it's like that guy, he's like so extra, like throwing like salt or whatever. I don't even know what he's throwing. That's like me like giving you guys advice about primers.
Yes.
Oh my God, this is my LA apartment. If you guys don't know, I moved in. I vlog like every single day. Seriously, I press the upload button every single day and you can watch it every single day. But this is my LA apartment. I love it. It's very yellow and happy, and I decorated it, and we're having a housewarming party on Friday. So I could do an apartment tour. If you guys want an apartment tour, holla at me and I'll do it. Just spam me and tweet me so I don't forget. So, I'm not like a huge foundation person. I like BB creams because it's just like lighter, and I don't know, this BB cream has SPF 15, so that's good. Protect my face from the sun. But since I'm Tana Mojo trash and I love Tana and I want to be Tana, I got the Marc Jacobs foundation because that's the one that she uses. It's actually really good. It's like putting actual paint on your face. Amazing, but it's literally like $100 million. So, I'm taking my Smashbox BB cream. This is the one that I mainly use. And I'm gonna be putting this baby all over my face. I put it on the back of my hand, and then I get a booty blender. Should I wet it? It's kind of wet from yesterday. No, I shouldn't wet it. Oh, got it. And also, quick tip is to always
always make sure that your beauty blender is wet, and beauty blenders are like so worth it. Don't buy like the Real Techniques ones, or get like the real beauty blender, because that thing is like truly like the beauty blender. I'm like, okay, I'm like the laziest, stressed out person in the entire world. So I got this like, it's a nude beauty blender, so when I use it, it doesn't look dirty. Like, that is why I picked the nude and not the original pink. So I'm taking that out of the back of my head and putting it all over my face, and oh my god, I was gonna... That's a little bit dark. It's okay. Why does it not match? I think I'm just so pale, because it's like, I live in Canada, so it's like, it's cold all the time, and like, you don't go outside, so I'm literally like white. If I showed you my boob or like my butt right now, it'd be like full on like white. And like, I'm half Filipino and half French Canadian, so like, that Filipino side comes out of me in the summer, and I'm full on like,
do you see the tip of this brush? That's how dark I was in Australia.
So like, my skin can't make up its mind, and so right now I'm just really pale, and that's like not good, because I just, foundations don't match me. That's my life story. Oh, that was so much smaller than I, why am I not single? This choker's actually choking me.
I'm gonna get kicked us out of the building. I like just moved in.
Sounded like a dying cow. Like sounding as if a, like a cow stubbed his toe on like a barn or something. Next up in our jar full of amazing things, I'm gonna be doing concealer. I'm not breaking out too much. I just finished my period, so it kind of like cleared up a little bit. So I'm gonna be using, this is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and it's like a liquid one. I really like to use like the pot concealers. I don't know, I feel like they pack on a lot easier on your pimple. And this one I just kind of like for like lightening my under eyes. So I'm gonna be putting this concealer underneath my eyes, in like a triangle almost, underneath my eyebrows, underneath my, or on my forehead, my cupid's bow, my chin, and whatever is left over I like to put like underneath my contour. I don't like to put too much, because then I look like really like white, and like not what color that matches my actual skin. Girl, let me get your number. I'm trying to think of a joke. Wait, this is my go-to joke. What do you call a sad coffee? Depresso. I told that joke like 5 times on my YouTube channel. Please unsubscribe. Okay, now I'm gonna be using the booty blender and booty blending away the concealer to make it more, you know. And this concealer is just like my favorite. I don't know. It's just like the wand is so big. And I like the big. I actually love big things. Like, I love big dogs. I love big cars. I love like big, like. I'm not trying to be like, I like big dogs and I cannot lie. You other suckers can't deny. You see a golden retriever walking in the street, you gotta look at his feet. And make him come to you. Lure him and pet him and love him. I like big cars and I cannot lie. Them SUVs are fly. When I see your rubber got a head on over him. I like big concealers that I cannot lie. You other suckers can't deny. When you see a big brush, you're like, oh my god, I'ma put this all over my face. Hey guys, it's Adeline the Rapper. Buy my songs on iTunes. It's really good. It's 129 Canadian. All right, blend it. Concealer, done. I really need to go outside. This is the first drugstore product that I'm using. And brush.
Beauty guru.
This is the NYC bronzer, and look, I didn't even just hit pan. I'm like fully like running out. Like there's like barely any left. I'm like scraping off the sides. I'm being so dramatic. There's a lot left, but this is like my favorite bronzer ever. A lot of you guys like bought this bronzer because you know it's my favorite and like brought it for like,
you guys know me. We ain't strangers.
So I'm just doing like, this is the 3E effect. Have you guys ever heard of that? Like on like YouTubers' videos. So you make like a 3 and an E on either side of your face. You go, and then the other is like, that's the 3E effect. It makes your face fleeky and nice and like, you know what I'm saying? Like Emma Watson, like Scream Queens, like, you know?
Her cheekbones are so nice.
Or like Dolan Twins cheekbones. Like, this is how you get the Dolan Twins cheekbones, I'm telling you. This is it. Next is blush. So, actually, okay. Out of all of the things that I'm about to show you, these two things are my favorite. One, these Skechers shoes, duh. And next is this Becca Jaclyn Hill palette. Insert like Christian Bible music now. Jesus. Like Jesus Christ himself, like, designed this palette and produced it to the world for us to enjoy. This is like the Rolexes of highlighters. I love this blush. This blush right here, like the most intense one. Tap off the excess. I like to just put it on like the apples of my cheeks. I like to put a little teeny tiny bit on like my forehead and like underneath like my jawbone. You can't even like notice. It's something that I have to do in order to finish it or else I just can't. Like, so blush, 3E effect, kind of, not really. And then this is my favorite brush for highlighter. Densest fan brush. Like it held this hair inside of it. Like so it comes with the gold one, but I like the normal champagne pap. I like to be papping, like champagne pap. And then, ready for this? Gives me chills every time. I love it. I love it so much. Other side. And I like to put a little bit underneath and over top of my brows just to kind of like even it out so it's like high points my face. And then K. Out of all of the makeup, out of all of the highlight, everything that I do in my makeup, this is my favorite part of the entire world, and it's like so easy. Ready? This little dab. Ready? That's my favorite part about my makeup, and I feel like it makes my nose look so like cute and buttony. Like, I don't know. But that little teeny tiny like flick of the wrist. That's what, that's literally my favorite part about my makeup. Ah! I love nose highlight. Rudolph the champagne nose reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, I would say hashtag slurred. Okay, next. Sometimes what I like to do is contour my nose so I can totally do that. And I like to focus it like, on the bottom because I have like my little like Filipino nose ones like laminate and the big and the, you know. So I like to focus on the bottom and kind of make it look a little bit smaller. Next, eyebrows. So the thing about me is I like get really carried away with my eyebrows, and I usually like would use my Anastasia Beverly Hills. Like you guys know I use this in like every single tutorial that I probably ever made last year. I use this for my eyebrows. But recently I feel like I've been filling them in like way too much. Like, I just make it too big for my face, and I feel like I look like I already look like 10 years old, so I'm gonna make myself look like 9. So I like to keep it like kind of thick, kind of thin, you know what I'm saying? This is just like the Maybelline Brow Precise Micro Pencil, and I love this. It's like Anastasia Beverly Hills. And it's in, what is it in? Oh, it says made in China. I don't get carried away with this pencil because it's like so little. I like to underline under it and over top of my eyebrow. Just kind of like fill in the bald spots. Ah! It just broke. I like to kind of make it so it's darker on the outside and lighter on the inside. I like how it's like an ombre effect kind of. So it's like Kylie Jenner. It's like the Kylie Jenner brow. It's like ombre. And I feel like it's a lot more natural looking like that rather than having it like all filled in. Lighter on the inside, darker on the outside. It's like an Oreo.
Lighter on the inside and chocolate on the outside, like
Oreo eyebrows, can that be a thing? My eyebrows are definitely not twins. Like this eyebrow is fully higher than this one. My like eyebrows aren't even like twins. They're not even like sisters. They're like, you know, like those distant relatives that you like kind of say hi to and your mom like buys a present for them for Christmas. Like that's like who they are. Like they barely know each other. Look at this. This eyebrow, instead of going like a normal eyebrow, goes this way. Why does my eyebrow hair literally grow the opposite way?
And then spoolie it up.
I just wish I had Zendaya's natural. Have you seen Zendaya's natural eyebrows? They're just perfect. I think I'm gonna do my eyes now, but I wanna first off like moisturize my lips. This is my favorite lip balm ever, and it's from Bath & Body Works. Who even knew? It's like the rose salve one. So I like to take this and put it all over my lips, and oh my god, I like threw up on that one. I'm gonna put like an actual lip color later, but right now I'm just like moisturizing it and making sure that it's not like, you know, like a desert. This is my favorite part. I love doing this eye makeup look because it's just like, it's so easy. Like it's like foolproof. Like nobody can do this wrong. So I'm getting some tape. This is some gift wrapping tape. My Valentine's Day presents. So I'm getting my tape. I put it on the back of my hand first just so it gets like a little bit of stickiness off the tape and it doesn't hurt when I like rip it off of my eye. My eye socket doesn't come out. And I like to put it as if this line, like if you were drawing me, it would just keep continuing on. So that's what I like to imagine when I'm putting the tape on. Like that.
Wonderful, darling.
Okay, so most of the time I switch between these two palettes. So I either use the Kylie Jenner palette or I use a mix of this and this palette.
Oh!
Wait a second. It's basically broken. Like, the palette that I've been using, like, the past few months has been, like, this Too Faced Semi-Sweet Chocolate Bar palette. I use this palette so much. I hit pan on, like, multiple colors and, like, I love it so much. I think I'm gonna use this palette. I have that new Halsey song stuck in my head. 50 Shades of Grey. I really, really, really like this peanut butter color, as you can tell. It's like basically gone. Kind of like orangey brown color. I like to put this eyeshadow on like the crease of my eye. And windshield wiper motion. And I'm also make sure that you bring it down to the tape, because what the tape does, it just creates like a really sharp, cool line, and it'll make your makeup look a lot harder than it actually was. And I love this makeup look because it's like you don't need eyeliner. So like, you know when you do eyeliner, like, oh, this one's good and this one's like a little bit bigger than the other one, so I'm gonna add a little bit more to this one, this one's too big now, and then like, and eyeliner is just like a mess for me. So like, I love this eyeshadow look because it looks like eyeliner, looks like, oh, and you put a lot of time in it, but it's actually like just black eyeshadow. It's really nice. Next, I'm gonna be taking Truffled. It's like a darker brown color. And I'm putting Truffled on the outer part of my eye. So that can be like on the crease and the lid.
I got fake people showing fake love to me straight up to my face.
My blended eyeshadow face. Yeah. Blending is so important. Make sure, blending. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, blending. Now, I think this is like the most intense part of the makeup look. This is a little teeny tiny eyeshadow brush of Eagle Tools. I'm gonna be taking Licorice. It's like this black eyeshadow and it's so pigmented. Very, very nice. I enjoy. Very nice. Good job, Too Faced. What I'm doing is I'm getting the black and I'm putting it as if it was like a wing. And I'm barely putting it on like my lash line. And I feel like Kylie Jenner has this look on all the time. Again, not really putting it on my actual lash line, like mainly just winging it, like I do with everything. And then kind of to blend it all together, I'm gonna be taking my blending brush and blending it all together. And then with a little bit of, this is Butter Pecan, it's like a champagne-y color, and putting that a little bit on the, I'm putting that on the inner corners of my eyes. I feel like putting a little shimmer in the inner corners opens up your eyes and makes your eyes look a lot bigger. Okay, ready for this? You doing? I love this makeup look so much, and you see it like kind of took off a little bit of highlight, so that gives me the excuse to put a little bit more highlight on. Back in with that light brown that we were using, this peanut butter kind of orangey-ish brown shade, I'm gonna be taking that on the blending brush, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be putting it underneath my eye. This is just gonna kind of like balance out the makeup, especially since we're gonna be putting eyelashes on, but I feel like this just makes you look like a lot more like sultry. I'm a big kid now, you know? I'm not 12, I'm actually 18. But I'm actually 18. I'm turning 19 in a couple days. Cool. So, my favorite eyelashes, I'll show you. I love the bulk packages because you can get so many and they're so cheap. They're like $2 each, which is so good. You can buy them individually, but they're like $5. What? I use these like once and then I like take them off and I forget where I put them, and then like Matt thinks that it's a spider and like gets scared of them. So I really like, these are the Kiss eyelashes in Poise. I also like the number 11. And then I also got the Sephora collection eyelash, and I think that this was like kind of expensive. I think it was like $9 or something like that. But it's in French number 4, and that's what I used within the last couple days. Oh, also, I used the black eyelash glue because I'm Tana Mojo. Okay, I'm gonna be using, you know what, YOLO, I'm gonna be using the Sephora eyelashes. The way that I put on eyelashes is, I get my eyelash glue, I'll narrate it in Gru's accent. So get the eyelash glue, and my minions put it on my hand, and then I get the tweezer. I like the Tweezer Man tweezers because it's made by men who make tweezers. First of all, these are really old freaking eyelashes, so they have lots of leftover glue on them. Make sure to pick it off. If you don't pick it off, you will look like mess. You look like Bob when he's trying to make my jam and he just cannot. I don't know what I'm saying. I like to bend it like this. And then I like to dip the eyelashes into the glue. You see what I did there? Freaking blurriness of my camera. You probably cannot see that. Do that. And then I wait. I like to place it on the thing. So I place it on this thing. And then I get the other one. And I dip this one in the glue too. And you must make sure. One tip that I can give you when you're doing your eyelashes is to make sure that you let it dry. Let your eyelashes dry. Because when you don't let your eyelashes dry, you know what happens? It gets all like liquidy. And then you put it on your eyes and then it goes like the wrong way. And then your eye is all like, it's a mess. So just wait for it to get tacky. Then I get my mirror and then I put it on. Don't know how else to explain other than just put it on. You just put it on. I have no other tips. I put it on the middle and then I fix the outside and I fix the inside. You'd have like the like most messy eyeshadow look in the entire world and then put eyelashes on and like bam, you like freaking patch your star up and you're like, you look like you slay the world. Like, okay, I left it dry. Ah, I messed up. Wait, Chloe.
What?
Do you want to be in the video?
Oh my god, we're just like, how do you talk on and on for that long? It sounds like,
I think
there's a whole party of people you. And you have all the different like languages too, like it literally sounds like
subscribe to Chloe, she did reality TV show videos, so.
Okay, thanks, Helga.
Helga?
Makeup looks good.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye. Imbecile. Beautiful, now we have eyelashes. See, don't I look like I look like I'm about to go on a red carpet because it's the eyelashes. Eyelashes make the biggest difference. My Forever 21 eyelash curler. It's my favorite eyelash curler. Literally all of my eyelash curlers are from Forever 21. This one's from a subscriber, by the way. I love you.
I'm gonna be curling my eyelashes.
Mascara. I'll try this one because it's the new one. This, ladies and gents, is like Manny MUA and like Makeup by Shayla's. And I'm like, slay, Maybelline partnering up with YouTubers. Like, please partner up with me. You're literally my favorite brand. With NYX, I feel like Maybelline and NYX, they're like my favorite because they're actually good. And they're like cheap.
This is the Maybelline, the Colossal Big Shot Mascara. Turn that into like a Maybelline ad.
Ooh, this brush.
Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of like blend my fake eyelashes with the real ones by putting the mascara on and kind of like gluing it more.
Showing fake love to me straight up to my face. My eyelashes are fake. Yeah.
Manny and Shayla, I approve of this mascara. Oh my god, are we done? Wait, lips. It's winter. My lips need to be moisturized or else it's literally gonna like dry out and be like the desert, like the Sahara Desert. So one thing that I've really been liking is Too Faced Sweet Peach Creamy Peach Oil Lip Gloss. And this one's in Papa Don't Peach. I would even go out like this, like a clear lip gloss I really like. But this one's just gonna add like a little bit of color, a little bit of schnazz, and it tastes like fuzzy peaches. Do you guys know what fuzzy peaches are? Cause I like Snapchatted about this and I was like, oh my god, it like smells like fuzzy peaches. And you guys were like, Adeline, the Americans might not know cause it's a Canadian thing. I'm like, Americans don't know fuzzy peaches? What the heck? Fuzzy peaches are like the best Maynard candy of life. Like, when you're trying Canadian candy, someone needs to do that. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna bring all of my Canadian candy. I'm gonna bring it to Chloe cause she's American. And I'm gonna make her taste all of my Canadian candy. Cause there's like, Coffee Crisp, Fuzzy Peaches, Ketchup Chips, all of the good stuff that I had no idea Americans like didn't know about. Kind of like moving into America and like getting an apartment in America, I just realized so many things. Oh, and a lot of you guys, I feel like, have been like so confused about like my living situation, and I've explained it in a vlog, but this is like a main channel video, so I'll like explain it in a main channel video. Basically, what's happening is I have this amazing apartment in LA, and I'm so excited about it, and so what's happening is I'm bi. Coastal, I'm bi-coastal. Not clickbait. What that means is I'm living like in two coasts. I don't know, like I'm living half of the time here in LA and half of the time in Canada, in Toronto. I'm doing kind of like what Nikki and Gabby are doing. So I spent like 2 weeks here and 2 weeks back. And a lot of you guys were like, are you and Matt breaking up? Cause it's like long distance. And we're not. We're like so happy. We have a really good relationship, I like to think. I like to see my family as well. And we're all good. It's just like, I took a year off because I had to go on tour. Like I can't just like go to college and then go on tour on the weekends. I took a year off, so I was like bored when tour was over. So I decided to come here. This is where I'm gonna get all of my stuff done. I have like a clothing line. I have like a website I wanna do, an app, a game, almost daily vlogs, almost weekly art, like main channel videos. Like this is where I get my grind together. And this is where I actually work. And it's like, I love it here because I live with Chloe, right? So like, I feel like we kind of motivate each other. Like, Adeline, stop procrastinating and actually edit your freaking Christmas video. But yeah, that's my living situation. I'm very happy and I hope that you guys like the new apartment. If you guys want an apartment tour, I will totally do it for you guys. Like a makeup collection. Yeah, just nag me to do it and I'll do it. That's what my mom does to get me to do the dishes. So that's, it should work for you guys, right? Oh, I'm gonna set it real quick. Kind of getting, oh, so little. Like less is more. And I'm just gonna be putting this on like the places where I didn't really set too much. And I feel like this powder kind of like makes my pores kind of go away. Something that's so important. Setting spray. These two are my favorite setting sprays. This is the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. And I like the mini one because one, you can travel with it. And two, it's like $10-ish. Another one that's really good is the NYX Matte Finish. Right now I'm gonna be using the Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. I look so weird when I do it, ready? Whenever I do it in front of Matt, he's like, what the heck are you doing, Helen? And I'm like, it's makeup. Like, this makes my makeup stay last longer. I feel like this and the Smashbox primer definitely makes a difference. It makes my makeup last like so long. But this is the makeup tutorial and I'm so excited about it. Adeline Moore has finally filmed a go-to makeup tutorial. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to give it a like and also make sure if you're not already, girl, you need to subscribe. It's free. I'm trying to upload like every week, you know, and we could be like friends, you know. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship if you just subscribe. And YouTube is so dumb. And they make it so you have to subscribe twice. So basically, if you're subscribed, you can click the bell. If you want to get notifications for when I upload and be like, oh my god, first, click the bell and be like, ayo. And like, you can also do that with my vlog channel too. Ayo. My tip of the day is, one, when you're filming a video, make sure that the microphone is freaking on. And two, do things that make you happy. For the past year or so, I've just been so out of YouTube. I had no motivation to post or anything. And I just realized like, why don't I just do videos that make me happy? Like, I was so concerned and worried about videos that like get views and stuff like that. But like, I feel like as long as you're happy doing what you're doing, you're gonna be successful. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and I'll talk to you guys later. Have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day.
And you try your best and you don't succeed.